saga that made motion picture history is coming back to home video. Digitally remastered for sparkling new versions with CD quality sound.
I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
You are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor.
Try to get us out of here!
You watch your language.
No!
I have you now.
The Force will be with you, always.
We have a new enemy. Luke Skywalker.
He will join us or die.
I'm not afraid.
You will be.
I love you.
I know.
Don't make me destroy you.
You must face Darth Vader again.
Wall fighters, follow me.
I will not fight you, Father.
It is your destiny.
The Star Wars trilogy will never again be available on home video in this original version. And it's coming to your galaxy one last time. And then, it's gone.
Each has a gift. Each has a power. Each has a purpose. And together, they will face their greatest adventure. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, the movie. The power is on.
He thinks you're Santa Claus.
I am.
You know what? I know.
You know what?
The secret.
What secret?
Santa Claus. I've known for a long time. He's not real.
Says who?
My mom.
I am the parent. You are the friendly guy down the hall.
They say that seeing is believing. But the truth is, the world is held together by things you can't see.
There really has to be something you want for Christmas.
A house, a brother, and a dad. That's all I ever want.
He loves you and he wants to kiss you. And he thinks he's the most beautiful woman in the whole world.
If you're really Santa Claus, you can get it for me.
What?
It's an engagement ring.
If you can't accept anything, faith, then you're doomed for a life dominated by doubt.
She's deaf. You don't have to talk to her. She just wanted to see you.
You are a very beautiful young lady. If I could make you believe, then there'd be some hope for me. If I can't, well, I'm finished.
I want this man declared insane.
This is about a man who has had something very wrong done to him. I want you to help him.
Together, we're going to prove that there is a Santa Claus and that you're him.
I'm ready, Counselor.
Do you believe that you are Santa Claus?
Yes, of course.
I'd like the court to see Mr. Kringle make the reindeer fly.
He only flies on Christmas Eve.
Coles believes in Santa Claus.
Do you believe in Santa Claus?
If this court finds that Mr. Kringle is not who he says he is, then I would ask the court to judge which is worse, a lie that draws a smile,
I knew it,
or a truth that draws a tear.
This season, 20th Century Fox, Richard Attenborough, Elizabeth Perkins, Dylan McDermott, and Mrs. Doubtfire's Mara Wilson present you with the most precious gift of all. Something to believe in. Miracle on 34th Street. directed by Les Mayfield. Friendship isn't something you find. It finds you.
Can we have this dog?
But it stays outside.
Yes.
20th Century Fox presents an extraordinary adventure about a friendship put to the ultimate test. As long as they had one another, they had a chance.
He's wearing a life jacket.
Wait! You got six senses, right? Go home.
What they feared, they faced together. And what they found in each other was the strength to do what neither could do alone. Far from home.
My parents really want me to finish college. I don't think you're going to have much luck.
Al Percolo was a scout who'd do anything to sign a prospect.
With the kind of money you make in baseball, many of the ball players hire tutors. Babe Ruth, Ty Cobb, Lou Gehrig.
Lou Gehrig? Didn't he also have a terrible disease?
Well, yes, he did, but he didn't get it from the tutor. I think he got that in college.
And in his Major League debut, Tommy Lacy.
Al, your kid won't come out.
Unfortunately,
I want you to use your change up sparingly, you understand?
I want to see you in my office.
Things weren't going his way.
Why don't you just fire me?
I like this better.
And Al's career was heading south.
Where I come from, that's a felony. No, thank you.
Until the day he discovered Steve Nebraska.
I have found the most astounding ball player that ever lived.
Want to be a New York Yankee?
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah.
Hey. Let me go!
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Nebraska.
Excuse me, I don't know what those signals mean.
Just throw what you want to throw.
Now the Yankees will pay Steve a fortune to play.
Before we pay him the money, we're going to need a letter from a psychiatrist or psychologist saying that he's all right.
All Al has to do...
Is this an emergency?
Well...
Yes.
Is prove he's normal.
What are you doing?
I didn't know how to describe this. I told him it was like a physical.
20th Century Fox presents...
Steve will look to you as a father figure.
I'm trying to fill those shoes. I'll do the best I can.
This is a father that Steve might want to put a bullet through.
How does he feel about his uncles?
The story of a player in need of a friend.
That's a chocolate baseball bat. I got it for you.
Did you drop it?
I got a little hungry.
And a scout...
Welcome to the first game of the World Series.
Whose idea was it to put Steve Nebraska up on the roof?
In need of a miracle.
Oh, my God.
Albert Brooks, Brendan Fraser.
I don't feel like playing tonight, Al.
You're the one that counts, not me. I'm just a stupid scout that was lucky enough to see you play.
You're like your dad to me.
But I'm not your dad. I'm just a guy taking 15%.
I thought it was 10.
The scout.
What was that? I didn't see a thing.
Trust me, it was a strike. Ah!
It has been buried for thousands of years. A mystery. A secret. Threshold to the future.
Where'd you find this? I've never seen anything like this.
One man will break the code and open the door.
Well, it should read Stargate. That was in front of us the whole time.
The other will lead the way.
Why are you here?
I'm here in case you succeed.
Jackson's identified the seventh symbol.
Backup storage, reserve power, on.
What is that?
It's your Stargate.
We've opened a doorway to a world we know nothing about.
The beam has locked itself onto a point somewhere in the Kalium galaxy.
It's on the other side of the known universe.
Your turn now.
They prepared for danger.
Begin final evacuation.
They expected the unknown.
Stabilizing system.
Initiated commencement sequence.
But they could never have imagined this.
right here and shoot anything that comes down that ramp.
Your job here is to realign the Stargate. Can you do that or not?
I can't.
What the hell is going on?
My orders were simple. Track down signs of any possible danger.
Well, I found some.
I can't make it work without the seventh symbol.
We have to abandon base camp!
You got 7 minutes.
Now, the most amazing discovery of our time.
Jackson, wait for me.
Is about to become the most extraordinary adventure of all time. Kurt Russell, James Spader, Jay Davidson. Stargate. A Roland Emmerich film.
He used a 9mm automatic. I promise you, this guy's killed before.
FBI Special Expert Warren Stanton is up against a killer unlike any he's ever faced. A killer no one has ever seen. A killer going where no one has ever been.
One of the men in your party is an imposter.
How many are up there in this fight?
5 fishermen and a leader, Sarah.
This is supposed to be a fun trip, not hell night.
Do you really think he'd kill any more of those people?
Jump. Jump!
Yes, I do.
But before Warren Stanton can take on the killer, he must take on a guide.
Ain't no elevators out there, mister. No cable cars, no buses.
Mr. Knox, you've got one choice, and one choice only. That is to guide me into those mountains.
This man is mine, you understand?
What the hell are these?
Battery-powered heated socks.
Sarah, Jonathan's coming.
That's your boyfriend, Sarah.
But you better keep up, because if you slow me down and Sarah gets killed, I'll kill you.
Two men tracking a killer and his hostage. One for revenge, the other for love.
Sarah! No!
Two men trapped in the middle of nowhere.
Stand, Dick! Come on, Dick, we're gonna die!
Now they must find in each other what it takes to survive.
You got frostbite on your face. Never seen frostbite on a black guy before. Look, kind of purpley splotches.
How does it look on a white guy?
White patches surrounded by red.
You got it too. Move in! I'm gonna pull the trigger! Let the girl go!
Sidney Poitier.
Let her go or die! You're crazy!
Tom Berenger.
Get out!
Kirstie Alley.
Run!
Deadly Pursuit.
Picture a man going on a journey beyond sight and sound. He's entered the demilitarized zone.
Good morning, Vietnam! Time to rocket from the Delta to the DMZ.
It's 0600. What's the O stand for?
Oh, my God.
It's Mr. Leo. You know, this whole camouflage thing for me doesn't work very well. Why is that? Well, because you go in the jungle, I can't see you. If you're going to fight, clash.
That is not what we program here.
Surprise, surprise, surprise.
You are not funny.
You're not going to last long here.
Boy, do I have a surprise for you.
Good morning, Vietnam.
In 1965, Adrian Cronauer was sent to do the impossible.
I was sent here on very strict orders from a colonel.
What the hell's going on here?
His mission? To build morale.
Where are you from?
Oh, from Cleveland, man.
Obviously, Vietnam's not that much of a change for you.
His strategy? Keep them laughing.
If someone is not telling the truth, you say that they are full of...
His problem? Staying out of trouble.
You want to stick to playing normal modes of music. Jim Nabors, Mantovani.
Percy Faith.
Percy Faith, good!
Yeah!
He did a very off-color parody of former VP Nixon.
Seeing as how the VP is such a VIP, shouldn't we keep the PC on the QT? Because if it leaks to the VC, you can end up in MIA, and then we'd all be put on KP.
Sir, the man is a walking keg of dynamite.
He's read unofficial news.
Ethel Merman jams Russian radar.
Hello, I've got a feeling.
What's he going to be like in 6 months?
Big dogs landing on my face.
What's he going to be like when he's 10 times as popular?
What's the weather like out there? It's hot. Damn hot. Hot and wet.
That's nice if you're with a lady, but it ain't no good if you're in the jungle.
Touchstone Pictures presents Robin Williams as Airman Adrian Kronauer, the wrong person.
Very attractive man, Ebersole. Don't think I haven't noticed.
In the wrong place.
This will not look good on a resume!
At the right time.
Good morning, Vietnam!
What a country. Heat, humidity, terrorism. Still, it's better than New York in the summertime.
Sooner or later, everyone needs a haircut. For the kids, there's the Butch or the Heine, the Flat Top, the Ivy, the Junior Contour, and occasionally, the Executive Contour. Me, I don't talk much. I just cut the hair.
You say he was being blackmailed. By who? You don't know. For having an affair. With who? You don't know. Did anyone else know about it? Probably not. You don't know.
You want to test something, you know, scientifically. How the planets go around the sun, why the water comes out of the tap. You got to look at it. But sometimes you look at it, your looking changes it.
Life has dealt me some bum cards. Or maybe I just haven't played them right. I don't know.
Life is just so damn wonderful, you almost won't believe it.
They put their pants on one leg at a time, just like you and me.
You keep your mouth shut. I'm an attorney. You're a barber. You don't know anything.
I'm not proud of what I did. You. What kind of man are you?
Science, perception, reality, doubt, reasonable doubt. I'm saying sometimes the more you look, the less you really know.
Every building, every room, every situation, a snapshot. I'm sitting here talking to you. I'm also checking the room, memorizing. The people, what they're wearing. Guy reading the menu. Threat?
Only to the hostess.
After 30 years in the service of his country, Nathan Muir is leaving the CIA.
Duty roster has you checking out tonight. On your way out, we need you to sign out your ID, card key, parking pass.
What's the date?
He's found his replacement.
Where'd you learn to shoot?
Boy Scout, sir.
Are you kidding me?
No, sir.
He's trained him well.
What else do I need to know?
Don't ever risk your life or your career for anyone.
It comes down to you or them, send flowers.
But just when he thought the game was ending...
We have to make it to the end of the alley.
You first.
Age before beauty.
All the rules changed.
It has just been confirmed that the Chinese have arrested an American operative of the CIA.
Now, a government betrayal.
There's been an incident in China.
What is this about?
Agency's looking for a reason to let the Chinese kill Tom Bishop.
We'll test two men's loyalty to each other.
Where are they holding him?
You don't need to know.
I'm gonna need an imagery analysis for a military prison near Suzhou. And if you use the phones, don't use these.
Any chance I could lose my job over this?
Tony Scott.
Mr. Muir has been working against us from the start.
You want to accuse me of something? Accuse me.
Director of Crimson Tide and enemy of the state.
I think you'd better tell us everything.
Robert Redford.
Do you remember when we could tell the good guys from the bad guys?
Brad Pitt.
I'm coming home.
They know.
They don't know.
They'll be waiting.
You got maybe 7 minutes.
No! No!
6 minutes.
Look, I know what I'm doing.
30 seconds. Get out now.
My game. Four sons of wise guys.
You know, the regular people, we're nothing but Goombas. But to our fathers, we're nothing but errand boys.
Looking for their shot.
If you jammed up here, there's got to be something I can do.
You brought us the sandwiches. What else can you do?
But no one wants to give it to them.
Listen, I can get this job done. Marbles has got a plane.
Marbles? He's half an idiot, and that is the good half.
See too many $100 bills around here.
I've stopped to get fuel.
Who has the money, Marbles?
Natty, I have no idea.
Where the hell are you?
Montana.
We're coming out.
Look at this place. Guys like us could be running it in a week.
Gotcha. A friend of mine lost a bag yesterday.
People around here are real careful with their property.
Because you wouldn't want to misplace your cow or nothing.
You are unlikable.
Sure, no strangers from out of town's been in here.
No stranger than you.
Looks like they're multiplying. Best we keep on our toes.
We've had a wrinkle. Cops are involved.
30 cops?
Yeah, he said cops.
You just tell me where I can find a little trouble in this town.
Used to be, you would have already found it.
We gotta make them beg us to take that money back. They're so scared.
You learn a lot of things on the way to 500 street fights. None more important than this.
Used to be there was a way to do things and things got done. Now everybody's feelings are involved.
They're gonna call their uncles and their fathers and they're gonna come here looking for the money. I just don't figure on them leaving empty-handed.
That's the thing. We can't let them leave.
Go time.
My friends and I here looking to get out of your town. But before we do, there's something we just can't leave behind.
At the country house of Sir William McCordle, the guests are wealthy.
If I wanted coffee, I'd have rung for it.
He thinks he's God Almighty. They all do.
Privileged.
Ooh, yummy.
What's she like to work for?
She's a snobbish cow.
Famous.
Mr. Wiseman's very odd. Apparently, he produces motion pictures.
Hello, I'm Morris Wiseman.
Who?
The servants are loyal.
I just wanted to be sure you had everything you need.
Discreet.
You shouldn't sneak up on people like that.
Don't worry, it's nobody.
Devoted.
Thank you. Oh, got some hair on your dress.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Wiseman, yep. Tell us about the film you're going to make.
It's a detective story. Murder in the middle of the night, a lot of guests for the weekend, everyone's a suspect.
And who turns out to have done it?
Oh, I couldn't tell you that. It would spoil it for you.
No, but none of us will see it. Why would anyone want to kill him?
Well, he wasn't exactly Father Christmas.
I think he's got something to hide, that one.
Do you think he's a murderer?
It's worse than that. He's an actor.
About that low bullet that nearly killed him that morning they were out?
Sir, we haven't dusted those things for fingerprints yet. Hmm?
Good.
Capital Films presents a film by Robert Altman.
I was just wondering if you wanted some company.
I suppose life must go on.
Alan Bates, Stephen Fry, Michael Gambon, Derek Jacobi, Kelly MacDonald, Helen Mirren, Jeremy Northam, Clive Owen, Ryan Philippe, Kristen Scott Thomas, Maggie Smith, Emily Watson.
Tough luck on whoever's got any secrets to hide.
Oh, how horrid.
Gosford Park.
Perhaps the butler did it.
Blaine, you know what? Let me go and get my tooth from all my pain and suffering. You know what I'm saying? Put them back. I'm getting earrings like Allen Iverson, fool. Put them back.
Ice Cube. Mike Epps.
First black president. Dum, 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 dum.
It's about trust.
Dig in my pocket. I want you to get something for me.
Wait a minute. We ain't that close.
It's about teamwork.
What did you shoot out the back?
Who you think I am, Mel Gibson, Danny Glover?
But mostly...
Come on, how am I supposed to get down from here? Jump! You better not let me hurt myself. I'ma catch you. Jump! Damn. Sorry about that.
It's all about the Benjamins.
How can we be so...
different?
Your teacher gave you a really hard book this time.
Why is he acting like a retard? He is. You're not like other daddies.
I'm sorry.
Daddy, I'm lucky. Nobody else's daddy ever comes to the park.
No one doubts that you love your daughter.
These shoes light up.
But your intellectual capacity is around that of a 7-year-old.
Do we get a balloon with these?
Yeah. All of us? Or just her?
Our concern is what happens when Lucy turns 8.
I find it is not in the best interest of the child to remain in the home, and I order her detained.
Why is Lucy going home with me?
It's time that you get your own lawyer.
This is one of the best ads I've seen in the yellow pages.
You're my lawyer!
Right, I'm your lawyer.
Okay.
We have a lot to go over, and I have 5 minutes.
Green means go.
You're going much faster than everybody else.
Is she going to help us?
Always set your dreams high, Lucy.
I don't think you realize what you're up against. You gotta be firm on this. You have to fight for her.
You don't know what it's like when you try and you try and you try and you don't ever get there.
I can go at least another 9 rounds, but you gotta let me in.
you think what they think. Sam can't take care of Lucy.
It doesn't matter what I think. It matters that we win.
It matters to me.
Isn't it true that you know you need much more than your daddy can give you?
All you need is love.
What makes you think you can raise a 7-year-old?
Every parent has those moments.
A 10-year-old.
Moments where the task is so unbelievably challenging.
A 13-year-old.
That you feel retarded.
She'll be 6 years more advanced than you.
I wouldn't want any daddy but you.
Did you hear that?
It's about patience.
I worry that I've gotten more out of this than you.
And it's about listening.
Daddy?
I'm here!
And it's about love.
I am Sam.
You're recording.
Hi, this is Sam!
It's an outgoing message, so I think you need to sound a little more outgoing.
This is Lieutenant Frank Grimes of Chicago Police Department. Are you the man in charge?
That's right.
Well, who am I speaking to?
John Q.
I assume since all the doors are locked, this is a hostage situation. Is that correct?
Okay. Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. I know you do things your own way.
Blood pressure is dropping fast. He's going into cardiac arrest.
But I don't understand. Mike's heart is useless. He's going to need a transplant or he's going to die. What made Mike so sick?
Transplant surgery is very expensive.
We got insurance.
There are no provisions in your policy for a procedure of this magnitude.
All right, you want money. I'll get you your money.
We've recently switched carriers.
We only give assistance to patients without coverage. I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Have you tried Medicaid?
No, you don't qualify. My son is dying. I'm broke. If I don't qualify, who the hell does?
I've done everything I can do. I'm sorry.
Please.
They are releasing him. Now you need to do something.
I'll take care of him.
Do something!
The hospital's under new management now. Everybody does exactly what I say, nobody will get hurt. More hurt. I want my kid's name on the donor's list.
This is going to end up bad for you, John.
Police will do whatever is necessary to preserve the lives of these hostages.
Well, they're telling me I got to take my son home and watch him die.
If you could speak to John Q right now, what would you say to him?
I'm there with you and you take care. 5:15, Frank. Something happens for me.
Are you praying for a baby?
Yes, I'm praying, sweetheart. He's a good kid. You'd like him. I am not gonna bury my son!
I got a shot at this guy and I'm gonna take it!
My son is gonna bury me!
Take the shot.
How's it gonna end, John?
I don't know.
Specials tonight. Smoked prosciutto with yellow tomato paste.
Serve your chop con savoy cabbage.
Pumpkin risotto with chestnut.
Mashed parsnips and potatoes.
Menu sounds delicious.
These people wouldn't know food if it hit them in the ass.
This is no ordinary New York restaurant.
We're out of the bookmaking business. These guys are not nice people.
Next thing you know, they want the restaurant.
Never the rest.
Here, the food is famous.
Keep everything in its place. Master here, all up front.
The chef is a star.
Up there's one of New York's most important food writers. Every morsel of food's gotta be perfect. Perfect!
Oh my God.
The customers are demanding.
Why do all gangsters hate homos?
There are two thugs at table 46 and they're asking for you.
I'm here to talk about a business proposition. I invited you here to talk about a bookmaking operation, not the restaurant.
But tonight, the most exciting things aren't on the menu.
Champagne for the cops, dinner for the crooks. Something that's not right here. You're amazing.
Pick a winner of his life depended on it.
25 years.
Nobody ever got killed!
When did eating dinner become a Broadway show?
Good evening. My name is Marty, and I'll be your waitress this evening.
My name's Fitzgerald. I'll be your customer. I always want to say that. I don't know why they tell you their names.
A car, you could pick me up in Colorado, we could have an adventure, you know, the two of us.
You'd want that?
How far would you go for the girl you've always
always wanted.
Sexy choice. Vintage 1971.
How much would you do for a brother in need?
Thank you for coming.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I'll drop him off in Denver. I'll see you tomorrow.
Everyone there!
This is like a prehistoric internet or something.
Can you do a woman's voice?
How much fun could you have?
Hey there, it's Candy Can. Who's this?
Rusty Nail.
If I were there, Rusty Nail, I'd make you feel good.
This is turning me on.
When the joke...
I'll be at the Lone Star Motel.
What room?
Room 17. I can't wait.
This is awesome!
...is now on you.
We had a little incident here last night. The victim was staying in room 17.
Dude, what happened to him?
Ripped his jaw. Clean off.
This fall.
Are you guys ready for an adventure or what?
Everything you say.
Candy cane.
We saw what you did to that guy. You pathetic, lonely freak show.
We'll come back to haunt you.
You really should get that fixed.
Get what fixed?
That tail, Mike.
Everything you see is going to terrify you.
Who's the pretty girl?
He's watching us!
Is going to drive you...
Go, go!
...over the edge.
Don't leave him alone! Please! We'll do whatever you want!
I want you two to head inside naked. So how does it feel to be the freak in the room?
Just for fun, just for a laugh.
You don't feel like getting together in a motel later. Room 17, do not be 1 minute late.
Cut open the door! Cut open the door!
So you still good or need me to drive?
One of the most explosive, brutal, and purely enjoyable horror debuts since The Evil Dead. Genuinely frightening. Jaws, Aliens, and Predator with a werewolf twist.
Come on!
Absolutely brilliant. Thrilling.
Mind your tongue!
Exciting. Scary.
I don't scare that easy.
And funny.
I'm sold.
A horror film with bite.
You what?
Search! I'm in the closet!
Bitch of a werewolf movie.
Fighter!
Dog soldiers. It'll blow your house down.
One's Luke.
This one.
12,000 gold ones for your head.
Move to the last frontier, far from the Wild West, the Wild East. Promise of gold made it easy.
What?
His little brother Elijah, though.
God have mercy.
Elijah's been on his trail like a hound dog.
Luke had a very good reason to get away from his brother. And here he is. Gun at his brother's forehead.
What you gotta do with this story anyway?
You'll see at the end.
Don't kill for gold. Kill for people.
Live your own life. 'Cause you die your own death.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Deep underground. In a top secret research lab, security has been breached. A deadly virus, capable of contaminating the entire world, has been released by Umbrella Corporation.
Oh my god.
We have to get out of this building! What was that? It's the break!
It's okay, we're here to help.
Now, an elite team has been sent in to stop it.
5 hours ago, Red Queen went homicidal.
Who's the Red Queen?
State-of-the-art artificial intelligence.
The corporation's keeping a few secrets down here. Something you're not supposed to see.
But they have only 3 hours left before it begins infecting and mutating the whole human race.
Everyone stay calm.
What's that?
She bit me, man! She took a chunk clean right out of me!
You have to get out.
Don't listen to anything she says. She's a holographic representation of the Red Queen.
She may be our only way out of here.
How is she still standing?
She isn't standing now.
No one is immune. Resident Evil.
You're all going to die down here.
Yeah, who's there?
Hey, it's me. I forgot my key. Open up.
Well, then, I guess you'll have to beg, huh?
Come on, beg.
I know you better open up the door before I... Just open the door, Lucky.
He was born with an incredible gift.
Anytime, ladies, anytime. Thank you.
To understand animals.
You just don't come up here on my balcony. Make an appointment.
Bring me a bone.
And a large order of flies. Supersized.
Now,
shall we put our cards on the table? By Friday, there won't be a tree standing.
With a forest under attack.
We can't fight humans on our own. Sure, I got rabies, I could bite somebody, but I can only do so much.
What are you guys, some kind of mafia or something?
I'm just a simple fisherman who's blessed with many friends.
A family out of control.
And I hate this place.
So young, so angry. Damn that rap music.
And the animal kingdom.
You guys have enormous untapped power.
None of them have any milk.
Strike.
Getting wilder.
Hello, Clarice.
Animals can't organize.
We can do it.
We have 2 bogeys. All units, commence bombing.
20th Century Fox presents...
You're an endangered species.
Hey, is that a threat, buddy?
Eddie Murphy.
How about putting a little sugar on Dr. D's lips, huh?
Smooth. Oh. In a comedy...
Get up! Oh! Oh! Funnel cake! Concrete broke my
answering the call of the wild.
Wait, one second. You gotta do that. Sit down on the toilet.
Dr. Doolittle 2.
Wow.
Oh my.
Woo! You sure you just had ice cream?
Wow. Was that me?
There were three wonderful things that I enjoyed in the 60s. My typewriter, the youth of those days, and lastly, the full discovery of the sea.
It was a time of change, of hope, of celebration, a time of revolution.
People that make art are dangerous to any dictatorship.
Artists are counter-revolutionary, and so you are a counter-revolutionary right now, Lorena.
Kevin Thomas of the Los Angeles Times calls Before Night Falls the best film of the year.
You're under arrest.
Why?
Because I said so.
Based on the true story of one man's dream of freedom and fight for survival. Before Night Falls confirms Julian Schnabel as a director of the first rank. Newsweek calls it passionate and powerful. Heroic in scale, raves the New York Times. A visually stunning masterpiece. Johnny Depp gives a triumphant double performance. Winner, Best Actor, Javier Bardem, Venice International Film Festival. Winner, Best Actor, National Board of Review. Winner, Grand Jury Prize, Venice International Film Festival. Nominated for a Golden Globe Award for Best Actor, Javier Bardem explodes on screen in an astonishing breakthrough performance.
My name for the moment is Reinaldo Arenas. I am a Cuban writer. I write and I survive.
Before Night Falls.
In 1972, in Hollywood, California, in 24 hours, six friends are about to discover
how you doing, baby?
What it takes to make it on the Sunset Strip.
Hendrix played here, man.
Yeah, can we just run it one more time?
Zach is ready to make it big with his show at the Whiskey.
If you want to come down, I can put your name on the list.
Felix is the songwriter who's way too pretty to be a rock star.
Is this you singing?
If it was me singing, do you think that I would be here? I'd be at the Hyatt with a girl with perky little breasts who thinks I understand her.
Tammy is the fashion designer who makes them all stars.
Oh, miss you, Marty.
Then there's Marty, the record guy.
I'm in touch with the ghetto.
Marty, get off it. You grew up in the valley.
Okay, that's the North Valley, man.
And Mike, the photographer.
Stop that.
Today, he's shooting Glenn's new album cover.
You gotta be special, Mike.
Really? For the third time.
Action, Glenn.
Whoa. I got an idea, my man.
Fox 2000 Pictures presents the true story of six people.
All right, kid, let's go.
In a time when innocence was over. And the party was just beginning.
This is Hollywood. We can do whatever we want to.
Jared Leto, Adam Goldberg, Sunset Strip.
For every band, there is a moment when they know they have made it. For one band, this is not that moment.
Thank you, guys. You're a great crowd.
Okay, girls, we need the lane now. And your shoes.
I'm a punk rock punk.
They were three small-town girls with big-time dreams.
Who's a rock star?
I am.
Who wanted to share their music with the world.
We can't sit around here waiting for it to happen.
We are musicians. We should be out there playing music.
We do play.
Nobody believed in them.
You know, you suck.
But they believed in themselves.
We're special.
Yeah, special, Ed.
Now.
I'm your backbone.
in a world of tough competition.
And that is so sad.
Fate is giving the Pussycats the chance of a lifetime.
We'd love for you to sign with Mega Records.
How am I gonna pull this off? I'm a girl from Riverdale. I'm not a rock star.
You gotta believe in yourself.
Things are finally going their way. But between the mania...
Is that Joseph?
They're gonna be huge!
The managers...
We decide everything.
What's hot and what's not.
Welcome to your party!
Who else thinks that Fiona's a freak?
And the media...
We're gonna be on TRL?
Mm-hmm.
This may be the toughest gig they've ever played.
Have you noticed that everything has sort of become all about Josie?
Josie.
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 Josie!
Josie!
Been around.
I made you a rock star.
Tell me you don't love that.
Forget it.
You know, I never liked you.
No matter what happens, we will always be friends first.
Are you gonna kill me with the guitar?
You messed with the wrong pussycat.
My bad.
Josie and the Pussycats.
Are few and far between in this world. Listen to me now.
20th Century Fox presents a love story so timeless and touching.
When you find yourself a keeper, you treat him the way he wants to be treated.
It could only have come from the people who gave you.
Come on, have some more. Excuse me a minute.
There's something about Mary.
Care for a taste of my pie?
No, thanks. I'm full.
A boy who never knew his parents.
I found your mother.
And her name is Suki Yamaguchi.
A girl who wished she'd never met hers.
Oh, my God! Stay absolutely still. I gotta go get my camera. Oh, God!
A romance changed forever.
We gotta save some for the honeymoon.
What are you saying, Gilly?
By one simple mistake.
Hey, Noble, I'm 110% sure.
Your mother's name is Val Bean Wingfield.
Sweet Lord, she's your sister.
Pervert.
We'll still see each other at family funerals. Bye, Gilly.
Make that two simple mistakes.
What do you want?
I finally found your mama.
Oof, he's your son. Who the hell is this?
Finally, I'm going to be able to set the record straight.
When the whole world turns against you.
You are the sick man. Primor! No.
She wasn't really my sister.
You can say it isn't true.
I'm not your brother.
Yo! Check out my banner!
Who wants to marry his sister?
Oh, my God.
You can say it isn't normal.
What's going on?
These men are gonna help you feel right again.
Joe, I don't need men to help me feel right.
But you can't say it isn't funny.
You guys just can't kidnap me like this. I'm an American citizen.
Say it isn't so.
That's what you get, you dirty little pervert.
How come you're here straight?
What? Maybe you ought to be wearing your glasses.
Yeah, but they make me look stupid.
Hey, pervert on the run. Go get it, Freddy.
It's time for Monkey Bone Live!
Stu Miley had it all.
The man behind the monkey.
Mr. Stupid Mopey!
But then it all slipped away. Now, he's gotta ditch the monkey.
I'm reporting this to my union!
What union?
The Sidekicks Union!
Dump the kitty. And come to his senses.
Whoa, baby!
The woman I love is living with a horny little monkey that looks like me.
But Stu here forgot to endow me.
Ooh! I'm letting it all hang out.
To get back.
As long as it's okay with Monkey Ball. Which it seems to be.
The lady got a loose caboose on a bow.
Say it! To the girl of his dreams.
Ooh, baby.
I'd love a stiff one.
Die, die, die!
Ow! Nice eruption.
How was she?
She was beautiful.
What a lucky girl.
Drinks for everybody.
Brendan Fraser.
Thank you.
I'll take the South Park guys instead. I hear they're dying to meet me.
Bridget Fonda.
See?
If it yells. If it swings. It's got to be.
Hiya, boss.
Monkey Bone.
Take off your clothes!
Drawn in by desire. Blinded by passion.
There's something that's not quite right about him. Like one of those men who can do awful things to people, but no one ever suspects them because on the outside they're perfectly normal.
Now, if you want more from this young man than just sex, then you must insist on knowing more about him.
The victim of seduction.
3 years I've waited for him. 3 years of my whole damn life, and now he's seeing someone else.
She gave him everything she had.
Did his wife know about you?
Now she must discover the truth.
He wanted me. You have no idea how badly.
You know, people have been known to go to very great lengths to maintain the illusion of a fantasy.
I know what I want when I look at you.
You should call the police. Because you're in danger.
Trapped in a world of deception.
Stay away from Paul. He killed his wife.
Look, whatever Carla says is fantasy. I'm real. I'm real.
Victim of Love. Coming soon on video. Based on a true story.
I spent 20 years in these mountains. I know these people.
A killer is on the loose.
I'm gonna shoot you dead as hell.
A community lives in terror.
This maniac shot at 5 people.
And unless we stop him, he'll keep coming back.
His next victim will be for life.
You took her!
What are you talking about?
Peggy!
Lieutenant, I've been after this maniac for 2 years. If we don't catch him quick, this girl's in real trouble.
I'll watch you for a long time up in your woods. Even watch you through your bedroom window once.
This kidnapper is no dummy. He doubled back on his own trail, which we just trampled all over on the way up here.
We hit track?
Where are you going to hide from me?
We've got a tracker coming in tomorrow, some kind of super dog. Says they can track anything.
If that girl is still alive, every minute we lose is critical.
You're not going to let me go now, are you?
You're mine.
You've got something against me personally, or is it just the Bureau in general?
Peggy!
I'm telling you, if my dog say Peggy Bradnick was alive, she's alive.
We're gonna move in to drive this monster out today.
Based on the true story of Peggy Ann.
You guys ain't any closer to catching him than you were a year ago.
Don't worry. I love you.
Cry in the wild.
We have every reason to believe that Peggy's still alive.
I'm never gonna try and get away from you again. Honest.
Coming soon on video.
It was the first motion picture to explore the innocence of natural love in a paradise filled with wonder. Now, the story continues for a new generation. Columbia Pictures invites you to return to the Blue Lagoon. Two castaways alone in a world untouched by time. Through the eyes of innocence, they discover their sensuality.
Do you remember what Mother said would happen when I became a woman?
Yes.
Become one.
Through the heart of danger.
I like the way it makes me feel.
They face every challenge nature has to offer.
It feels all alive.
Until the day civilization invades their island paradise.
Get away from me!
I want us to be husband and wife.
And tests the boundaries of their love. Return to the innocence. Return to the mystery. Return to the passion. Return to the Blue Lagoon. Out of innocence comes the most sensual love of all.
Everybody knows that the dice are loaded. Everybody rolls with their fingers crossed.
Everybody think about it. Everything's polluted. The environment, the government, the schools, you name it. We're on 92 FM tonight, and it feels like a nice, clean little band. No one else is using it. Price is right.
Are you listening to this?
Yeah, of course I'm listening.
There's nothing to do anymore. And all the great themes have been used up, turned into theme parks. So I don't really find it exactly cheerful to be living in
a totally, like, exhausted decade where there's nothing to look forward to and no one to look up to.
He's got a pirate radio station. Nobody knows who he is.
I could be that anonymous nerd sitting across from you, and then you turn around, and he just looks away. Never looks back at you again.
This is a song for the 90s.
Welcome to Doreena's Mitchell, may I take your order, please?
Yeah, I want...
That was deep. I like the idea that a voice can just go somewhere.
Uninvited, like a dirty thought in a nice, clean mind.
I know you. Not your name, but your game. Come to me. Or I'll come to you.
So you are him.
I do. What I give for a kiss? What am I gonna do? Why can't I?
Guess who? It's me again with a little attitude for all you out here in white bread land. It's 10 o'clock. Do you care where your parents are?
Oh, Dad! I'm in jail!
This radio person is the whole problem. Are we going to allow this guy to be heard by anyone who can turn a dial?
I'm in jail! I'm gonna stay here! I like it here!
And he's trying to tell you that there's something wrong with this school.
I'm in jail!
You're not supposed to be here.
What do you
want to
slam me?
Come on, Bill,
I'm a big fan of yours.
Get off the bus.
Get off!
Son of a troll. Why not do something crazy? It makes a hell of a lot more sense than blowing your brains out.
Go ahead and get some.
FCC, you know what that means?
This phone call has been traced.
This is my life you're screwing around with me, you know?
Not anymore, it isn't. This is everyone's life. Mark, you can't leave it like this.
You out there? You listening?